Hi everyone, welcome back. So in the last some videos, we studied a lot of different concepts such as ion items, ion images and labels, and I think we are now in a position to go forward in our quest to build this test application. So let's dissect this application, what we actually want and what are the things or UI components that we'll be needing to make it happen. So see, it is a list. We have not yet studied list, and that is what we are going to do in this video. And this is a list of some data, and as you can see, this particular thing, it is an item. We have an image and two labels and an arrow in this item. So as a first effort, we are going to make this item, and then we are going to learn some more things about a list, and then we are going to learn about fetching data from a TS file and displaying it onto the screen, and later on we will move to calling an API. So let's start. This is our application at present, and let me make an ion item that is similar to this one. So to do that, I will make an ion item. Then we need this ion item to be clickable, so that when a user clicks on it, he will be taken to another page, that is a descriptions page. So we, if you can recall, there are two ways by which we can make an ion item clickable, and that is by using button attribute and by href attribute. Button attribute is used to call a functionality on the click of the ion item, while href attribute facilitates navigating to a different page on clicking the ion item. So we are going to use here href. At present, don't worry about the page where the user will be taken, just put the href tag. Let me save it. Let's go back, and this is our ion item that is invisible at present because we have not yet put any content inside it, but we'll do it soon enough, don't worry. And then we need a small arrow, so that can be achieved with the help of details attribute, or that was just detail, I guess. And here is our small arrow. So congratulations, we have got something to see in this item. Now we need an image. So if you remember, we studied about different types of tags that display an image. One of that was ion img, the other was a thumbnail, and an avatar. Avatar was used to display a profile image, a small profile image, or a brand logo. And at present, this small image represents a miniature image of a bigger image. So we will be using here ion thumbnail. Here is ion thumbnail, and ion thumbnail is a wrapper element, so we would need another ion tag, that is ion img, that will contain a source attribute that will point to our image, and that is which is kept in assets folder. So our ion thumbnail is in position, and here is our thumbnail visible. The next thing that we will need is a label. So let me put a label here, I with the help of ion label. And as it is, as the product is a Bluetooth speaker, so let me give it a proper name. So here is our label, and now we need one more label that will display its price. So let me put another label here, and for at present let me just put a dummy or static data. When we can't change the data, it is known as static data. Now see, we have almost got what we wanted, but there is some space needed between this image and this text. So let me give it a space with the help of some inbuilt functionality, that is ion margin end. So if we put this class, we will get a small margin at the end of this image, that is to the right hand side. Let me just save it and see, we have got a margin. The second thing, this label is not full, it is displaying an ellipsis. So in order to see the whole label, let me give it a class of ion text wrap. Guys, we have discussed all these things in our previous videos, so if you have not if you don't recognize what it is, so please go to our last videos. So as I put an ion text wrap, so I think we have achieved what we wanted. I'm not putting this dollar sign at present because this is the thing that we are going to cover in the next video. So I think we have achieved somewhat of our target. Let me remove all the other things now because these are now used up. So our ion item is in place. Now there is one more piece of information or tag that we need to study, and that is ion list, because we have to display a list of items. We have prepared one item, but we need a list. So guys, let's study list. Let's go to UI components, that is the official documentation for ionic. Let me search for ion list. Here it is, and let's go through the documents. Lists are made up of multiple rows of items. Okay, so lists are made up of multiple rows of items, and we have got one item which can contain text, buttons, toggles, icons, thumbnails and much more. And we have got our ion item, which has got a thumbnail and two labels with it. So list generally contains items with similar data content, such as images and text. Yeah, we all know what lists are. We have seen them on WhatsApp or on Google Hangouts, Google Chats, and our contact list is an example of an ion list. Oh, sorry, not an ion list. It is an example of a list. A list supports several interactions, including swiping items and all that. Okay. So let's do one thing, let's do some coding. This is ion tag for ion list. Let me put this ion item inside this ion list. And let me do one more thing, let me just copy paste this ion item 3 times so that we can see a list. Oh, as we can see, we have a list of 3 items at present. So let's see what ion list have to offer. List supports several interactions, including swiping items to reveal options, dragging to reorder items within the list, and deleting items. So guys, we are going to just see the basic customizations that we can do on lists. The advanced options we are going to do in the videos to come, when we are going to really need them. So here are some usages, and see if you can notice ion list contains an ion item, and an ion item contains an ion label. So I think it is a preferred way of using ion list, and just prepare an ion item with some stuff and put them repeatedly inside an ion list, and we have got a more complicated ion item here then in the example. So I'm not going to demonstrate this to you. You can play with it on your application, on your turf, no issues. In the next example, if you can see, we have got an ion list again with ion items, and all the ion items are made up of labels and input elements. So again, copy them and paste into your code inside the ion content area and see what and how it displays. List of sliding items. Okay, now this is something interesting. So let me just copy and paste it and see what it has to give. Let me put it on the top of our list. Here it is. I like indented code, and so I have indented it. And let's see what it has to offer. Okay, our images are gone, and I don't know why they are gone. We'll see to it later. Let's first see what this iron item sliding has to give. Okay, if I'm trying to slide it, nothing is happening. But see, if we observe it, give it a deeper look, you can see there is something written as side end. So I don't think anything is going to happen if I do something here. What if I slide it from here? Okay, guys, I think you might have sometimes in your mobile phones went to your call logs and messages, and when we swipe it, we get a handful of options such as delete or archive or read. So these are the options that we can put if we go through these, if we put these iron tags inside an iron list. But we are going to just learn it as it is. So let me just delete it now. It is an example and you are free to play with it. Let's see some more options. These are the examples. Let's see some options. Properties, inset. So if true, okay, it's a boolean value, the list will have margin around it and rounded corners. Inset, so let's put this inset on the list. At present our list is aligned to the hamburger icon just above, and if I put an inset to be true, let's see what happens. Save it, and okay, it has just moved somewhat to the right, and some padding or maybe some margin has been applied to it. So inset gives it a padding of, the default padding is actually 16 pixels, so it could be 16 pixel of padding. Okay, let's go to another property, how the bottom border should be displayed. So there are some properties, full, inset and none. So I think we all know this property, lines. At present our application is having, our list is having lines. So let's put something, and let me just remove this inset because the lines inset property may collide with it. So if we just delete everything and have a normal list. Okay, now we have a normal list. Now let me put lines inset, and as I put line inset, nothing happens because I think lines inset is the default property. If I remove it, nothing happens, and if I put it back, nothing happens. So it means that the inset value of lines is the default property of iron list, and we can change this with the help of full. Let me put full here, and I'm 100% sure that these lines will now stretch to the leftmost corner as well. And yes, it is, the lines are now full, and the next is none. So I think it will disappear or make the lines invisible. Make it none, and now we have a list without lines. Okay, so I hope you get the idea. Mode, it's okay, iOS and MD, and the methods, close sliding items. Okay guys, this method or the some more methods that may be there, we are going to study them only if we need them in our application further. So I think now you guys know clearly what an iron list is, and you can copy this code and paste it in your code and play with them. I think we have got what we wanted. Now in the next video we are going to see how to iterate over this list and get data from a TS file and display it without the need of copying and pasting items statically. So guys, thanks for watching this video and stay tuned for the next one. Thanks.